Good morning. Today we will continue our grammar rules for first secondary past tenses. We will start the past perfect simple. As you know, past perfect simple is formed by had plus the past participle, had plus the PP. For example, I had played, she had done, we had visited. We use the past perfect simple for many reasons, in many cases. Number one, to describe an action which was completed before a specific time, a specific point of time in the past. So if we have two actions, one preceded the other. So we have two actions. Action one should be in the past perfect, and action two should be in the past simple. So my mom had done the washing up by midnight. So before a specific point of time, like by midnight, by here means before. So my mom had done the washing up. Remember that we use had with all the pronouns, all the nouns, whether it's singular or plural. Number two, with adjectives in the superlative form and expressions like the only, first, second, etc., when referring, of course, to the past. It was the first time I had seen an elephant. It was the first time I had played tennis. But take care, if we have at the beginning, it is the first time, we are going to use present perfect. So if we have the first part as past, we are going to continue in the past tenses. Then slide number three. Also, we can use the past perfect simple to describe an action that was completed before another one. As we said, in the past, the second action is in the past simple. So my friends had already eaten when I got to the restaurant. So here we have two actions. My friends eat, so this is the first action. They had eaten because it happened at the beginning when I got to the restaurant. So if we have two actions that happened, one happened before the other, we use past perfect simple for the first and then past simple. And as you can remember, past simple is the second form of the verb, like did, played, put, began, drank, swam. Then slide number four. As for the time expressions, we have many of them already, every, never, just, when, by the time, after, by, before, and many other keywords. But remember that these words are shared in many tenses. Already is a keyword here for the past perfect simple, and we can use it in the past perfect progressive or the present perfect, depending on the meaning. Plus every, we can use every, as you know, in the present simple. So take care that they are not indicating the tense without thinking. So we have to think of the sentence before we choose according to them. Then slide number five. We will move to past perfect progressive. For the past perfect progressive is the form had, been, verb plus ing. Like I had been working, this is affirmative. He had been sleeping. As I said before, we use had with all the pronouns. I, he, we, they. As for the question form, had, subject, been, verb, plus ing. Had you been working? Had she been sleeping? As for the negative, we only put not beside had. So they hadn't been working, it hadn't been sleeping. Then slide number six. When can we use the past perfect progressive? We can use the past perfect progressive to emphasize, to focus on the duration of the action that was in progress before another one. So we should have two actions. Again, one happened before the other, but we are emphasizing, we are focusing on the duration, the time. Or a specific point of time in the past. He had been living in London for 15 years when he moved to Glasgow. So here we are stressing the duration that he had been living in London for 15 years. So the main focus here of the verb of the sentence is the duration, not the verb itself. So if we are focusing on the action, we are going to use past perfect. But if we are focusing on the duration, we are going to use past perfect progressive. Also, we can use past perfect progressive to refer to an action whose duration caused visible results. Visible means obvious, I can see them at later point of the time in the present. So something happened and the results are obvious, are clear in the past. They were tired because they had been cleaning the house all day. So both the actions happened in the past. The result is clear. They were tired. So this is the result of the action. Where is the action? They had been cleaning the house. We can use all day as a keyword for the past perfect progressive. Then, slide 7, we also have some time expressions like already, by the time, for, since, after, before, when, and how long. As I mentioned before, we can use these keywords for many tenses. So take care that they are not only the main indicator for the choice. Then slide number 8, used to. We use used to plus infinitive, like I used to work, he used to sleep. And for the questions, did you use to work? Did she use to sleep? They didn't use to work. This is the negative form. It didn't use to sleep. But when can we use used to? Of course, for a habit that you used to do in the past and you are no longer doing this action. Slide number 9. So we use used to plus infinitive to describe permanent past states, a permanent situation in the past. I used to be overweight when I was younger. So here, the main verb that is followed by, that came after used to be, is be. Remember that be is a stative verb. So usually with stative verbs, we use used to. I used to be overweight when I was younger. Number 2, to describe past habits, something I did in the past for a very long time. My father used to drive to work, but now he walks. So he used to do this action in the past, but now he doesn't. Number 3, to describe repeated actions in the past. We used to go out every day. So here, as you can see, we can use every day in the past. We used to go out every day, but we don't anymore. Slide number 10. Take care that we can use used to, but before used to, we can use am, is, are, used to, plus noun or verb plus ing. It means that we are familiar with something because you have done it or experienced it before and it doesn't seem strange, new, or difficult. So I am used to waking up early in the morning, I don't mind it. So something that I didn't do in the past, but I'm starting to get familiar with it. So if we add verb to be before used to, we are going to put after used to noun or a verb plus ing. And in this case, it means that we are getting familiar to something. Also, we can use get used to plus noun or verb plus ing, which means to become familiar with something or get to know it so that it is no longer unusual or strange. So something that you couldn't do, but now you can do it. I haven't got used to working the right shift yet. Then slide number 11. Now we have another expression, which is would plus infinitive. I would work, it means in the past, of course. Would you work? He would sleep. Would she sleep? This is a question form. And for the negative, they wouldn't work, it wouldn't sleep. Remember that would usually is followed by base form or the infinitive form. Then slide number 12, we use would again to describe past habits. My grandmother would always wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning. But remember that if we have used to and would in the same sentence, we are going to choose according to the main verb. If the main verb is in is describing a state, is a state of verb, we are going to use used to. As the example we said before, I used to be overweight. But with would, we use would in order to describe past habits. My grandmother would always wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Wake up here is not a state of verb, so we can use would. Number two, to describe typical behavior in the past. If we are describing something that we did in the past, again, we can use would plus infinitive. Every night, Linda would turn on the TV, sit down on the sofa, and drink a hot cup coffee after dinner. As you can see here, we have successive events, some series, three actions. Linda would turn on the TV, so this is number one. Two, sit down on the sofa, then drink a hot coffee. So if we are describing a typical behavior in the past, we can use would and not used to. Then slide number 13. Also, we can use would or was going to in the past. I was going to play. They were going to move. So we can use would plus infinitive if we are referring to the past things or the past four things that we expected to happen at a later time. I knew he would pass the examination. So this is an expectation in the past. So with expectations, we can use would plus infinitive or was, were, going to plus infinitive. To talk about actions that somebody intended to do in the past, but probably didn't. So I was going to visit my cousins over the weekend, but they came to visit me instead. So I intended to do something, but I didn't do it. So if I intended to do something and I didn't do it, we can use was, were, going to, plus infinitive. Now we are going to answer some questions. For choose the correct answer. Number one, by the time I went home, I 100 pages. So we said that by the time is a keyword for the past perfect. By the time usually followed by past simple, then past perfect. So I had read. So number one, C. Then number two, we arrived late. And by the time we sat down, the film, of course, had started. Because we have two actions. One happened before the other. So the first action was that the film had started. Number three, Ali, for work for over a year. So here the main focus is on the duration before he finally got a job. And as we said, if we have two actions in the past, the first action should be in the past perfect. But here, because the focus is mainly on the duration over a year, so we have to use C, had been looking. Then slide number 15. Mona was tired yesterday because here we have an obvious result, was tired. So again, the main reason should be in the past perfect progressive. So the answer is 4B, had been revising. Then number 5. When we woke up, we saw the streets were flooded because it all night, again, all night, all day for the past, we use it for past perfect progressive. So when we woke up, we saw the streets were flooded because it had been raining all night. Then slide number 16. Bashir didn't feel well today. He, for only a short time, last night, when the phone rang and woke him up. So again, we have an action that happened in the past, and we have a focus on the duration, for only a short time. So we can use had been sleeping. Then number seven, my clothes were dirty because I the car all morning. Again, we here have all morning, so had been repairing. Then slide number 17. As soon as I met him, I knew I him somewhere before. So we here have two verbs again. I knew I had seen him before. So 8a. Then after, on time the film started. Remember that after here is not followed by any pronoun. So we have to use verb plus ing. After arriving. So if after is followed or is not followed by a pronoun, I, you, he, she, it, it's usually followed by a gerund. Verb plus ing. Then number 10, by the time my mother aged 30, she five children. Was had or had been having. Remember that have is a state of verb. So we cannot use verb ing with the state of verbs. So number 10, B. Then 11, I for half an hour before I realized that I was dangerously far away from the beach. Again, the main focus here is on the duration. So 11, had been swimming. Then slide number 18. Years ago, after Zakaria school, he worked on a farm. So here we have two actions. He had left school, then he worked on a farm. So 12D. Then 13, Maryam looked so happy when we saw her last week. Perhaps she, of course, she had got some good news. Then 14, just after, again here we have after, that is not followed by I, we, or any pronoun, so we have to use verb plus ing. Just after cleaning her flat. Then the last one, slide 19, Amr ate a sandwich during the break because he enough time to eat before it started to rain. So again we have two actions here, so because he hadn't had enough time. Then the last one, Jane recognized the old friend though she had for a long time. She hadn't seen B. Thanks for listening and bye.